As a person who's into history, I always get fascinated reading about stuff that has been forgotten or never been discussed. This is true with technology, especially when it's ahead of its time. But what if I told you that there's an 18th century gun that could fire up to 22 rounds of ammunition without smoke coming out of it, with the added benefit of being able to operate in the rain? You might think that I'm making this up, as there's no way that an 18th century gun that I described existed. Considering that breech-loading guns weren't 18 yet, let alone being able to hold multiple rounds of ammunition. Meet the Ghirardoni air rifle. If I'm going to describe this rifle, I would say ahead of its time. Granted, there have been many inventions that could be labeled as ahead of its time, and this is no exception. But for a weapon that could do the impossible, surely the army would have taken notice for such a feat. But instead, it faded into obscurity, while muzzleloaders still became the standard until the mid-19th century. But why? That's why I'm answering this question. The Ghirardoni air rifle was developed in 1778 by an Italian gunsmith, Bartolomeo Ghirardoni. It was chambered by a .46 caliber musket ball, with the gun weighing in around 10 pounds. As stated before, the weapon's main feature is that it was designed to fire multiple rounds, with an ammo capacity of up to 22 rounds, via a tubular fed system. As for the gun's mechanism, unlike most muskets at the time, which used black gunpowder, the Ghirardoni air rifle uses a pneumatic system, using air as a propellant rather than gunpowder, hence the name air rifle. This is accomplished via a pressure flask located in the buttstock, and once fully loaded, it could be good for up to 80 shots before being repumped. This system has many advantages, as without the use of gunpowder, the Ghirardoni air rifle could fire smokeless rounds, in addition to being silent in the midst of combat. But its greatest advantage is that it could be used in bad weather, such as the rain, making it an ideal weapon for sharpshooters. When the Ghirardoni air rifle was first pitched to King Francis II of Austria, he was quite impressed with the gun, and for such an innovative weapon, he suggested that the rifle should be deployed to the best units, as he believed they'll be far too difficult to train a regular soldier, given the amount of complexities. With that said, the Ghirardoni air rifle was issued to Tyrolean sharpshooter units, and it was used in combat during the Austro-Turkish War with great effectiveness, according to the soldiers who used them. As to what extent is uncertain. Sources say that they used whatever the Tyroleans were deployed, or used in certain battle scenarios, such as sieges or special operations, similar to the commando carbine used by the British during World War II, in terms of use. The most notable use of the Ghirardoni air rifle was during the Lewis and Clark expedition, in which they displayed and demonstrate the rifle's capabilities whenever they encounter any Native American tribes, as a musket was not enough to impress the Native Americans on its own. Other than demonstrations, the only time the gun was used in anger was when a local warrior was killed when trying to steal the gun from the expedition. But by the start of the Napoleonic Wars, the guns had begun to phase out, and although there are some rumors to the contrary, the guns were never used against Napoleon's army, and were taken out of service by 1815. With the Ghirardoni air rifle being the most advanced gun of its day, why wasn't it used more extensively? Well, for all its advantages, the Ghirardoni air rifle was very expensive and difficult to produce in large quantities. And since it was made before interchangeable parts, the gun is also difficult to repair, as very few gunsmiths had the capability to repair a rifle this complex, not to mention that the mechanism it fired could break easily, so it's not uncommon for the rifle to be discarded after multiple breakages. It also needed air pumping stations to fill the air canister, which takes about 1500 strokes to fill one full canister. So, if the pumping station or canister was damaged, the gun would be rendered useless. The Ghirardoni also required a high 800 PSI to have an effective range of 150 yards. In comparison, the Brown Bess has an effective range of 170 yards, which, although it doesn't seem like a huge gap, if the Ghirardoni was using a canister that's not using the required amount of PSI, the range would reduce significantly. Lastly, as mentioned before, the Ghirardoni require a lot of training to be used more effectively. By and large, the Ghirardoni air rifle was an innovative rifle, yes, but technology, cost, and logistics was too much for the gun to be used in a massive scale, and although it faded into obscurity, the idea of a repeating gun would eventually become a reality with the introduction of the Spencer's repeating rifle. There have been so many projects that are considered wonder weapons, but they either don't work on practice or just too stupid to be considered practical. But in the case of the Ghirardoni air rifle, I think the technology at the time wasn't available to meet the demands.
Why you locked up?
Because I didn't wear any underwear when equipping my dress.
Well, you know the risk.